Welcome to another Color Wednesday. Today I'm using this stamp set from Art Impressions. This is the Little Behind set. It's really, really cute. It has the front of this really big cat and then his bum. And then it actually comes with an action wobbler. I've already taken it out and used it on a different card, so I'll be adding an action wobbler from a separate package. But when you do buy the stamp set, it comes with an action wobbler so that you can try it out yourself. So first I'm starting out with some watercolor cardstock. My card is going to end up being 4x4, but because I've got that action wobbler that I'm going to be putting on the inside of the card, I want it to have a little bit of like a wider fold. So I've accounted for 1/4 inch in the center here. So for the fold. So I'm gonna bring it in and I'm going to score it at 4 and then also at 4 1/4. So 4 and then 4 1/4. And that'll just give a little bit extra room. So if you were going to mail this card to someone, you would need to put it into a box. Or what I'll do is I'll probably just be saving it to give to a person on top of a gift. So it would be, you know, by hand. So that's the extra give that I've accounted for. I'm going to make that flat because I'm going to do some watercoloring. All right, before I get to that, I'm going to go ahead and stamp the cat image so that I can watercolor him as well. I'm using Jet Black Stazon ink and then the cat's face right there. I'm gonna keep that Stazon out because I'll use that for the sentiment on the inside of the card. I'm using a watercolor set from Sakura called Koi Watercolors Pocket Filled Sketch Box. It's for when you're traveling and you want to watercolor while you're out and about or in fields or in nature or whatever, but it's also a really great watercolor set for card makers. Comes with these sponge things on the side that you can get wet that keeps your watercolors moist, but I don't use that. And also comes with a water brush, but I'm going to be using a Tim Holtz water brush today. Got some scratch watercolor paper from when I cut down my card base, so I want to make sure that I have a clean brush here. All right, I'm going to just do kind of a wash of water, leaving a little bit of a border around the card. All right, and then I'm just getting the center wet. Okay, and I'm going to bring in some color. I think I'll start with this color here at the bottom. I want it to be kind of a really intense blue, so I'm going to add quite a bit of pigment. All right, and I'll just start dropping in that color. All right, and then I'm going to grab a yellow. And the yellow and the blue are going to mix on the paper and create a green color for me. And then I'm going to bring that in and grab a red. Actually, before I get to the red, I want a little bit more yellow. So I need more of a true yellow, like a golden yellow. There we go. And then I'll be bringing in that red. And drop in a little bit of orange to get those colors mixing. All right, so I'm gonna let that dry while I paint the cat. So I'll just set this aside. And now I'm going to paint the cat, grabbing a smaller watercolor brush here, and I've got some black started already. All right. And I'm going to paint him like Manny. You guys know I love Manny. So I'm going to start on his behind. Manny's tail is all black. So I'm just bringing in that black on his rump, on his bum. All right, and then he does have pink toes, little pink pads on his feet. So I'm going to grab just a little bit of red, and I'm really going to water that down because I want it to be a really pale pink. That'll work. Let's add a little bit of pink right there down on his feet. I'm also going to add some pink over on his ears. Just right there, and also get his nose. All right, I'm going to take some of the black and move it to another spot on my palette and really water that down because I want a really light gray so that I can add shadows. That'll be perfect. So I'm going to put a little bit of shading right there on his feet and under his belly. I'm going to be cutting this out, so going over the edges and it doesn't matter. All right, I'm going to be adding black to this one, but since I've got that light gray color going right now, I'm going to go ahead and add the shading under him and on the sides of him, probably right under his little face. All right, I'm going to hit this with my heat tool just to dry that pink so I can paint black right up next to it. All right. And since this is going to be Manny, I need half of his face to be black and half of it to be white. So I'm just going to paint around his cute eyes. And his back is black, but his belly is white. So I'm just going to paint the sides there. Perfect. All right, so now I'm going to hit this with my heat tool, and I'm also going to do that for the card front as well, just because it is pretty wet still. And I'm going to take a circle die. This is from Sizzix, and I'm going to be putting it kind of more near the top of the card, about right there. And I'll just tape that down, and I'll run it through my die cutting machine. And just like the watercolor piece from Monday's video, running it through die cutting machine does flatten it out quite a bit. And now I can save this circle piece for something else. All right, I'm going to take my scissors and cut out the cat. All right, I'm going to add just a little bit more black watercoloring. And that is because the back side of the inside piece will be showing. So I need to just paint it with some black so that it's not as obvious. And it kind of blends in with the rest of the front of the card. So just the top half about to that point. And I'm also going to add a black frame around that die cut area. I want it to really stand out. And the indentation from the die is showing just a tiny bit, so I'm going to use that as a guide to just paint a frame. So now it has a black frame around that. All right, before I adhere anything, I'm going to add some dash lines with a white gel pen. Just around that black frame. All right, and now I'm going to put the card together. So the cat is going to go on the front just like that. Looks like he's hanging out the hole. So I'm going to put just some Tombow Mono Multi Glue, and I'll be putting that just on his feet and right along his belly. I'm going to pull that off before he's dry. All right, I'm gonna have to fix that little spot there. I keep forgetting. I need to have the card open like this. Silly me. Okay, so I'll just take that watercolor set one more time. Gonna fix my mess here. I'll have to use a black pen to fix it up right before I finish up the card, but for now that'll work. All right, I'm gonna have to add some more glue. And the cat goes down here at the bottom. Okay, there we go. That's because I want it to be like when you open the card, it's not as, he won't be upside down. So that when you open the card like this, the back of him will be right there. Whereas if he was right here, you'd have to flip him up and then he'd be upside down. So that wouldn't make sense. Okay, so now I'm gonna worry about the back with the cat right there. Like I said, he's going to be in an action wobbler, and I think the action wobbler is going to be just a little bit too big. So I'm going to be cutting off the sides a little bit. So I'll take the backing off one side. I'll take the backing off the other, and then I can carefully place this right over where that cat is. So now front, you can see his tail from the front of the card, but on the inside he's got his little wobbly bum. I think that's so cute. All right, so now I'm going to work on the sentiment for the card. All right, I'm going to use my pencil and I'm just going to mark what can be seen. Okay, so I know I have this area down here that won't be showing from the front of the card. So I'm using some Stazon ink once again. And the sentiment from the stamp set says, always a little behind. I think that's so funny. So, get that flat. And I'll just come in and stamp that right there. And then from the Simon Says Stamp Birthday Messages stamp set, there's a little tiny stamp at the bottom that says happy birthday to you. Just erase those pencil lines that I left. There we go. Taking a black marker, and I'm just going to color this area so it's not quite as obvious. Using some white thread. This is just regular embroidery floss thread. So that's the card for today. Hope you guys enjoyed. All the supplies for this card are listed down below in the video description or at my blog. I also want to let you guys know that the mail call video for March will be uploaded next Monday. I'm going out of town, so I just need a little bit of time to film that when I get back. So it'll go up on Monday. In the meantime, I'll have a new Friday Focus video for you on Friday. And until then, thanks so much for watching. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up and hit the subscribe button. You can visit my blog at kwarnerdesign.com. And here are three more videos for you to check out for some additional card inspiration. Click on any of those right now and you can go and watch those videos. You can also catch me on Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, and Instagram. And I hope you guys will go and check out whatever I'm doing over there. I usually post pictures of my cat, Manny, just different things I'm working on. You just catch up with me over there. So thanks so much for watching once again, and I will catch you guys next time.